Hi guys, my name's Lindsay, and today we're going to take a few minutes and look at multiplying fractions and mixed numbers together. And if you're looking at these questions going, what is that dot? That dot is just another way of writing multiply. I often don't use the x because it can be confused with the variable x. So dot means multiply. And what I have written up here at the top says denominators don't need to be the same. If you have been working through dealing with fractions and you started with adding and subtracting, you'll know that these two, if we were adding those two together, we wouldn't be able to do it because the denominators aren't the same. We'd have to find a lowest common denominator to be able to do that. But in multiplying, the denominators don't have to be the same. So this question is actually quite a straightforward question. I just need to multiply straight across. I multiply the top number times the top number, so 2 times 3. And then I multiply the bottom number times the bottom number. Again, that's different from adding and subtracting. They don't stay the same, they change. You actually do multiply them. So 5 times 7 is 35. So the answer to that one, 2/5 times 3/7 multiplied straight across is 6/35. So it is pretty straightforward when you think about how much work goes into adding and subtracting. But when you get to multiplying of mixed numbers, there is a little bit of an extra step. Denominators don't need to be the same. So if I'm going to multiply this, I don't have to create common denominators. But what I can't do is I can't multiply 2 times 3 and get the answer and then multiply 1/2 times 1/4. I have to make these into improper fractions. So what I mean by that is I can't have a whole number out there. It needs to be incorporated into that fraction. So the way that I'm going to do that, and I'll write again over to the side here, if I've got one whole and I'm dealing in halves, hopefully it makes sense to you that one whole would be equal to 2/2. Every whole is equal to 2/2, which means if I have two wholes, I would take my two, my big two, and multiply it by my denominator, 2 times 2, that big 2 represents 4/2. So if I want to rewrite this, I am going to multiply my big number by my denominator. So 2 times 2, which gives us our 4. But then I can't forget about that 1 that was already up there, so I have to add that 1 in. Denominator stays the same. Let's take a look at this second one. The method stays the same. How many quarters are in 3 wholes? Well, the way that I can figure that out is 3 times 4. 3 times 4 is 12. But again, can't forget about that guy that was up there in the first place, that 1, so he needs to be included in there. So denominator stays the same. It's a 4. Now I'm going to add those together. 4 plus 1 is 5. So 5/2 is the same as 2.5, but this is a mixed number. This is an improper fraction. An improper fraction is just a fraction where the top is bigger than the bottom. Let's do the same for this guy. So I've got 12 plus 1, which is 13. The 4 stays the same. And now I've got 2 improper fractions, but I can multiply these just straight across. So I am going to do that. So 5 times 13, which is 65. And then 2 times 4, which is 8. I've multiplied it, and 65/8 is the correct answer. Although it looks a little funny because it's an improper fraction and you probably wouldn't say, can I have 65/8 of an inch of something? That doesn't really make any sense. So we are going just to take one step to reduce that. And the way that we're going to do that is we're going to figure out how many whole times 8 goes into 65. And if you're comfortable with your times tables, 8 times 8 is 64. So 8 goes into 65 8 whole times, and it's used up. When I wrote that big 8, it's like I've used up 64 of the 65 on the top. So I've got just 1 left over. So I'm left with 1/8 left over. So our final answer is 8 1/8. So hopefully that makes sense. You need to make those into improper fractions before you multiply them. So why don't you take a minute, try that guy on your own. You can see here that this guy is actually not a mixed number, it's just a fraction, so you don't have to do anything to that one. But for this one, take a minute, make this into an improper fraction, multiply them across, get your solution, and then try and see if you can maybe reduce it if it needs it. And I will come back in a minute and go through the solution with you. I'm back and I'm here to quickly go over this solution with you, if you did it, which hopefully you did. I've said this before in our series of videos, but I'll say it again. The only way to get comfortable with math is by picking up a piece of paper and a pencil and doing it. And just by watching me do this, you're not going to retain as much as if you actually take a minute and try these questions. So 3/4, I don't need to change anything with that. I'm going to leave that alone, leave my multiplication sign alone. But here I need to make that into an improper fraction. The method we used over here was I took the big number, multiplied it by 8. 2 times 8 is 16. So there's 16 eighths represented in that whole 2. Can't forget that guy though. That's one extra eighth. So 16 plus 1, 17. And the 8 stays the same. And now I can multiply straight across. So I'm going to do 3 times 17. And then I'm going to do 4 times 8. Sheesh. There it is. 32. Took me a minute to do that one. And that's my answer. The answer is correct, except that, again, we have that situation where 32 can go into 51 how many whole times? So we've got, and you know what? If you've got a calculator, and I have mine here somewhere, your calculator may actually have this capability. If I type in my calculator 51 divided by 32, this is just a division question. So if I type that in, my calculator actually gives this to me as my reduced fraction. So your calculator may have that function as well. And if it does, why not use it? And that will help you get your fraction in reduced form. So hopefully that clarifies the method of multiplying both fractions and mixed numbers. Hey guys, I'm back and I thought of one more thing I want to add to this video, so I'm just going to take a quick minute and clear this off, and then I've got one more concept that I think would be really valuable for you to understand. All right guys, I'm back for the last time, I promise, but something I wanted to talk to you about quickly was the word of, and the reason I'm throwing this at the end of this video is because of, the word of means to multiply. So it's actually a really cool, handy tool to know of when you're in the shop, for example. If you had a piece of product that was 7/8 inches long and you wanted to know what half of that was, what you're really doing is finding half of 7/8, and we could rewrite that. Since of means multiply, we could really just write half times 7/8. And when we do that, 1 times 7, the 7 doesn't change, but we multiply the denominator, 8, by 2, and we find that half of 7/8 is 7/16. We just doubled the denominator. Same works with 1/4 of 7/8, for example. If you wanted to know how big 1/4 of 7/8 was, you could think of that as 1/4 times 7/8. So what you're really doing here, the numerator stays the same, but the denominator, I'm going to multiply it by 4. So 7/32 is the same as, or sorry, is 1/4 of 7/8. And hopefully that was worth sticking around for another minute of this video to understand, because it can be a really helpful tool for you in the shop or in life in general.